Yes, hi guys. We are doing 15th question. Now in this question, we have secant x power 1.2, not 3 by 2. Actually here it is 3 by 2, I had noted down here. But that is, that resulted into a negative gamma power, or gamma of negative number, but that negative number of gamma, beta and gamma are only of positive numbers. So that cannot possible, so this is only 1.2, and I checked it. 1.2, our students will ask me, this is 3 by 2, but power is 1.2, only possible 3 by 2 will give us negative gamma. Okay, so that negative gamma of negative power, or negative numbers, or negative integers, cannot be found out, cannot be calculated. So, this power is 1.2, second power half. So, half taken half power here. So, what is the value of this? Now if you convert this in our solution, you have to find out the value of this question. Solution of this question is just we have to convert this in sine and cos, then you will apply the formula which mentioned here in the 11th question. We are given 0 to pi by 2, here also 0 to pi by 2 limits are there. Okay, then sine is for n theta cos n theta, in that way we have to express this, and finally we will result in the find out the best simple form of the gamma functions. Okay, now let me convert this into sine and cos. So sine already is sine over 2 cos. This can be written as 0 to pi by 2. This is sine x whole power 8 by 3. Okay, into this is 1 upon cos. That means 1 upon cos theta cos n, sorry. Cos n whole power 1 upon into dx. Now we can take cos x in the numerator. We will have here sine x whole power 8 upon 3 into cos power minus half into x into dx. Now this is in the form sine m theta cos n theta is m here. This power can be written here sine of 8 power 8 by 3. Okay, so that will work. Finally, the answer will be for the answer of question number 11. We check the 11th question here. This is nothing but first is gamma. Okay, let me write here 1.2. Within bracket, this is 8 by 3 here plus 1, m plus 1. Okay, this is written down as m upon m plus 1. Okay, then second is here. Second is also 1.2. Here it is minus half power plus 1 divided by twice whole gamma. Again 1.2 within bracket n plus n plus 2. N is here 8 upon 3. N is minus half plus 2. Okay, so finally we have to solve. We have to calculate the value. This is how much? 8 plus 3, 11 by 3. This is 11 upon 6. Why? Because if I take 3 LCM, it will be 8 plus 3, 11. 11 upon 3 into 1.2, that is 11.6. Gamma 11.6. And what about this? This is half. In the bracket, it will be minus half plus 1, that means plus half. You can multiply it with this. This is gamma 1.4 divided by twice the gamma. Complete value. This is minus half here. Okay, if I take 6 LCM, if we take 6 LCM, it will be 16 minus 2 3 6, that means 3 plus 6. Sorry, 6 to 12 here. This is 12. Okay. 6 to 12. This is 12 here. Finally, we obtain gamma is 11.6, gamma is 1.4, divided by twice the gamma. This is 16 plus 12, 28 minus 3, 25. 28 minus 3 is 25, 26. This is the answer here, gamma. But we can cancel out some of the value, but no need of it. This is the only answer. We can substitute of this. Or if we want to change 11.6, we can change it. 5 by 6 into 1 or 5 by 6. That is 11 minus 1. 11 plus 6 minus 1. 11 minus 6 is 5 by 6. 5 by 6 is gamma, 5 by 6. And here, 25 minus 6, that means 19 upon 6 into gamma, and no middle. Only this gamma. Okay, so this is the final question number 15 we have done. Now let me talk about the next question. What is the next question? Let me take 16 questions now. Question number 16 is the law of water current. Let me check it. Question number 16 is a very good. Okay. Now we have question number 16 is a very good. Evaluate sum of integration, it is a to b limits. Okay, this is in the bracket x minus 4 power n, okay, this is power n into b minus x 4 power n, okay, into dx, into dx. Here m and n are positive. Here n and n are positive. Yes. Here n and n are greater than 0. Positive numbers. Okay, they are positive numbers. They are wrong. Okay, now let me substitute something. So, solution of this, or evaluation of this, under solution. Here we have to substitute something. As we have done this kind of question. A minus x, b minus x, sorry, x minus a, b minus x. This kind of question we have done number of times and number of questions in the previous lectures are done. In the same way, we have to assume something. Putting substituting, let me put, putting x is equal to b sine square theta that we take, plus b cos square theta. The differentiating it with respect to differentiating c with respect to theta, we get, what do we get here? It will be ds, dx d theta, that is a, d theta dx, it will be twice a sine theta into cos theta, it will be minus sine theta, twice b into cos theta sine theta, cos theta, and then cos theta is going to be minus sine, minus sine, the same that is sine theta cos theta. So it can be written as taking the twice common b minus a sine theta into cos theta, or this is dx equal to d theta. This is the value of dx. What are the limits? What the limits are? All the limits we have to find out here. When x is equal to b, here in this limit. Okay, when x is equal to b, if the b is equal to upper limit, b here is the upper limit, lower limit, at b, x is equal to b, what is the value of theta? That will be my logic. Here it is, b is equal to a sine square theta plus b cos square theta. If I take this b cos square theta to this side, it will be b common. Now let me take this b cos square theta to this side, it will be 1 minus cos square theta. This will be a sine square theta. It is nothing but b into sine square theta. This will be a sine square theta. Or we can write here b minus a sine square theta equal to 0. Or theta equal to 0. Because sine theta is 0 for sine 0. Sine theta transfers to sine square 0. That means theta equal to 0. Theta is 0 here. This b minus a is divided by 0. 0 divided by b minus a equal to 0. Sine square theta equal to 0. Simplify that. Let me write here sine square theta equal to 0. Or sine theta equal to 0. That means sine 0. That means sine 0 dB. That means theta equal to 0. At x equal to a. Okay, now second point is this, at b is a 0. probability 0 and touch A, we can find out the x. We can do it first, no problem. Okay, and if the epsilon will add epsilon to A, the port A. A here is A into A is equal to A times the theta plus B for this with theta. For A, if I take common here, it will be A into 1 minus sine square theta. Okay, this is equal to B cos square theta. That means A cos square theta is equal to B cos square theta. You can add here A minus B is cos square theta equal to 0. For cos square theta equal to 0. For cos theta equal to 0. That means cos quadratic. Your cos quadratic is 0. Therefore theta equal to 5 by 2. Theta equal to 5 by 2. So minus are 5 by 2 to 0. That is that here. But before that, let me find out what is x minus a, b minus x. That we have to find out. So minus are 5 by 2 to 0. This we have calculated. And further, I have to calculate. Limits are here. Let me substitute here. Therefore, limits are 0 for 5 by 2 to 0. Okay, this is 5 by 2 to 0. Negative sign comes here. Then we will reverse this 0 to 5 by 2 to 0. Before that, minus sign must be there. Now let me find out what is x minus a. X minus a. Substitute the value of x here, which is a sine square theta, b cos square theta minus a. So it will give us a if I take common. Now let me take this is b cos square theta minus if I take common. It will be 1 minus sine square theta. So it is nothing but b cos square theta minus a into cos square theta equals to b minus a. This is value of x minus a. That is b minus a cos square theta. That value is not open. Find out what is b minus x. And b minus x is the second part b minus x. We have to find out. B minus x is b minus these two values which are negative. B minus a sine square theta minus b cos square theta. If I take b common, it will be 1 minus cos square theta minus a sine square. So this is nothing but b cos square theta minus a sine square. And b minus a sine square theta. And let me b minus a sine square theta. Yes, that we have. That was b. So here it was b minus a sine square theta. B minus x is this value. Now let me write down here. And this is again b minus a. And in the denominator we are getting a because dx is there. And let me substitute all the values here. So if I take substitute all these values, we get x minus a first. What is x minus a? X minus a is here, b minus a into cos square theta, b minus a, b is power n, b minus a over power n, into cos twice n over cos square theta, over power n, that means cos square theta twice n into n, into theta, this is what x minus a is. X minus a here. The first equation is the second unit. The second part is b minus a. This is b minus a whole power n here. B minus a whole power n into sine twice n theta. Twice n power, because whole square, sine square theta is here. It is whole power n, sine square whole n, that means sine twice n. Okay. So let me put out this. Okay, this is twice here. Now here are two. Ds is okay, negative sign. Here it was negative sign. Because this was twice E. It is negative, this is positive. So this is negative sign. So then we can make it B minus A. Because it is twice B negative, this is positive B. Twice A positive, that is positive. It's negative sign. This is minus twice. Negative sign is here. Right. So the value is obtained as minus twice. Because twice B is what? Dx upon B theta. Okay, so dx is equal to, this value is negative. We have to take minus twice B common, twice, minus twice common. Then B minus A will be, B minus A, one theta positive, this is negative. Negative sign, this is twice into B minus A, sine theta into cos theta into B theta. This whole value we have substituted. This negative sign has come up. So this will give us the reverse of the powers, I mean, limits. Let me reverse the limits because of this negative sign. Negative sign, we change this limits from the definite integer property. The property of definite integers, we have here that the limits are intersects. Okay, then positive sign will come. Negative sign will become positive because of reversal of powers. I mean, reverse of limits here. This is 0 to pi by 2. Not pi by 2. You will know negative sign is enough. This is definite integer property. Okay, now let me write what is sine theta, what is cos theta. B minus A, B minus A, B minus A. This is one power on the twice. Two let me take out of the packet. And this is also B minus A, one power N plus N minus, sorry, plus 1. This is plus 1 here power. This is N, this is N. N plus N plus 1, whole power, B minus A. Now this is into sine. Now this is twice N plus 1. Why twice N plus 1 power? Well, this sine theta is also there. Sine twice N theta. Okay, now let me take cos. Cos is twice N plus 1 here, cos theta 1, both is there. This is first twice N plus 1. This is another ticket. B minus A also out of the B minus A. Whole power N plus N plus 1. All positive values. Positive power sign. Now this is 0 to 5 by 2. For the value of this is twice N plus 1 theta into cos twice N plus 1 theta into theta. Now from 11th question, what is the value of this? Okay, so the value of this thing. Okay, now this is B minus A. Next question, okay. If the answer is good, let me now find out. What is the answer to this question? This is beta M, M plus 1. What is beta M plus 1? And look at that. This should give us twice B minus A whole power N plus N plus 1. Now this is nothing but gamma 1 upon 2 within bracket. Let me put it like this. This is 1 upon 2 within bracket twice N plus 1 plus 1. And first one, then second one, gamma 1 upon 2 in bracket twice n plus 1 plus 1 divided by this value is there, twice gamma. Okay, now this value will be how much? Sum of these two, 1 upon 2 within bracket, it is twice n plus 1 plus twice n plus 1 plus 2. This is equal to. Okay, n plus 2. 1, 1, 2 is also there. This is the answer of this. But let me further solve it. Let me write the answer here. If I mean the answer at this way. Twice b minus a whole power n plus n plus 1. Okay, comma. But this is twice n plus 2. That means twice divided by 2. Twice n plus 2. We find the comma. We need only n plus 1. Comma n plus 1 divided by 2. This is twice. Here we have m plus n plus 2. So this is 4. Twice n plus twice n plus 4 divided by 2. That means this is nothing but comma n plus 1 and b. Comma m plus 1 plus 2. So then this is what? Comma n plus n. This is what? Comma n upon comma twice comma n plus n. Okay, this is the value. This is of beta mn. Okay. Of answer is, let me write here. So this answer was beta mn that we have. And beta mn, right here, this is the question, but beta mn is also expressed in the same way. Beta mn is gamma n, but this is n plus 1, which is beta m plus n plus 1, right? This is nothing but twice. Bracket beta minus a whole power n plus n, and this is beta n plus 1 n plus 1. This is the value of beta n plus 1. This is the final formula. Final answer is this. Okay, now question number, next question. Okay, now question number. 16th, we have 17th question, right? Let me talk about 17. So this is the final one. So this value is beta n plus n plus 1, n plus 1. Okay, beta n plus 1. And this is twice b minus a whole power n plus 1. And this value is beta n plus 1, n plus 1. This we know. Now let me take 17th question. What is 17th question 6? Now we have some doubt on the third one. Question number 17. Yes, 17th question is prove that to prove here what we have to prove here to prove that 0 to pi by 2. Okay. 0 to pi by 2 sine 1 power twice n. Is it minus n? Twice n minus n theta. Is it cos twice n minus n theta? N to d theta divided by k. This is within bracket a sine square theta. This is b cos square theta. This is whole power n plus n. Is equal to gamma n upon twice into a raised power n b raised power n equal to gamma n plus n. This we have to prove here that this whole value is this. Now beta mn. That we know about. What is beta mn here? Beta mn. This is beta mn. But put this value. Let me write that. And beta mn will be equal to this, that from there. Let me find out the value. Okay. We know that solution. We are finding out the solution. Question. For the solution is question. Let me find out. Now here, we know that. Okay, we know that beta mn is equal to that is there. 0 to infinity. E raised power minus s. If e for and let me extract this part. This is x raised power n minus 1.
By write it as
n minus 1 of n minus 1. First is n here. Okay, no problem. Whatever you write. So y raised power n. N minus 1 divided by 1 plus x whole power n plus n. This is the value just like this. This is in terms of value y. We have taken x here. The problem y can compute take beta m in question number 8. We have here gamma n, or gamma n plus n. But this is in terms of this improper integral 0 to infinity of the y upon y equal n max plus y equal n plus n dx. This is the value they are giving me. This let me take one. Now substitute the value x. What are the substitute here? X equal to let me take sine of theta. And for sine, let me take substituting this. Just we know that putting here, we have to put putting x equal to let me take a upon b. Our a sine square theta upon b cos square theta. That means a upon b into tan square theta. This we have to substitute here. In place of x, if I substitute a sine tan sine square theta upon b cos square theta or a upon b into tan. Now differentiation of this will give us bx equal to differentiating it with respect to theta. We get dx is equal to this twice a upon b into tan theta into second square theta. This is the differentiation of a upon t tan square theta. That means twice tan theta into tan theta is again differentiate, that is x square theta. Okay, that is the value of the question. Now, dx is this, what are the limits here? Let me change the limits. Well, here we have substituted x equal to this value. What are the limits? For the limits, they are 0 to infinity. Okay, 0 to infinity we are here. Okay, now let me take 0 to infinity. What is infinity for? N theta is there. For limits, let me change. For limits, at x equal to x equal to infinity. Okay, infinity equal to a upon b tan square theta. Tan square theta will be infinity because divided by bx and a. A upon b in 0, sorry, infinity will be infinity. So nothing but 10 square pi by 2. Or 10 pi by 2 is infinity. This can be 2 theta equal to pi by 2. At 0 to 0, and when at x equal to 0, theta equal to 0. So 10 theta is 10 0, theta equal to 0. So the limits are changed from 0 to infinity. Okay. And this is the value of dx. Now let me change that. Whole value. Substituting the value there in this equation. Okay, let me take first equation. So in first substituting these values, let me write here. Okay. Substituting these values here, we get 0 to pi by x is a upon b. This is okay. If I write sine square theta upon cos square theta, everything that will give us sine square theta cos theta. That will be better. It will be sine square theta, that is twice n minus 2 theta upon cos twice n minus 2 theta. A upon B, and A is power n minus 1 is equal to A. In case of X, we have substituted A upon B sin x square theta upon cos square theta. Then it multiplied by n minus 1 also. This is the value in the middle. Into that was twice into A upon B. Tan theta is sin theta upon theta. And second square theta is 1 upon 4 theta. Into B divided by, in the denominator we have 1 plus A upon B sin square theta upon cos square theta whole power n plus n. What a function. Both of this. Let me solve it further. So finally, what we get? We get here 0 to pi by 2, 0 to pi by 2 here. Okay, and yet A upon B, A upon B, and from this B will also come out. B cos square theta whole power n plus n, that will also come out. Let me first solve them. So this is A is power n minus 1, and this is power, okay, A is power m is coming. So I have to take here, because this is beta m, and if I take here m, if you take here m, this can also be taken m minus, because beta m first we are taking. If it is nm, then it can be m. Here it is n. So this value will be right here. And this is also n. Okay, this is also n. What we are given here, and in answer, a is power n. From there you can imagine this is actually power n minus 1, not n minus 1. This m minus 1 here, the denominator we have n plus n. That is not changed, n plus n is not changed, but only numerator, if it is beta n, but beta nn, that power will be n minus 1, the numerator, that is the only logic here. Now, come to the center. This is A is power n minus 1, from B is power n minus 1, and this is twice n minus 2, okay. All these values are here. Now, let me find out. This is A is power, okay, n minus 1. And this one A is also there, so this A is power n.